Today, I will talk about interleaved practice from the perspective of learning English vocabulary. Interleaved practice is a learning technique that involves mixing different topics or types of information during study sessions rather than focusing on a single topic or type of information at a time. This approach contrasts with blocked practice, where learners focus on one specific topic or type of information in consecutive sessions. The concept of interleaved practice is supported by cognitive psychology research, including the study conducted by Rohrer and Taylor in 2007. When applied to learning English vocabulary, interleaved practice involves studying words from different categories or topics within the same study session. For example, instead of studying all the colors in one session and then all the animals in the next, interleaved practice would involve studying colors, animals, fruits, and other vocabulary items all in the same session. This approach might initially seem counterintuitive, as it requires learners to constantly switch between different types of information. However, research suggests that this mixing of information actually enhances long-term retention and application of knowledge. The benefits of interleaved practice in learning English vocabulary include 1. Enhanced discrimination. Interleaved practice helps learners better discriminate between different vocabulary words and their meanings. When words from different categories are mixed together, learners are forced to differentiate between them, leading to a deeper understanding of each word's unique characteristics. 2. Improved retrieval. Mixing vocabulary items in a session requires learners to engage in frequent retrieval of information from memory. This retrieval practice strengthens memory traces and helps in the long-term retention of the vocabulary. 3. Transfer of learning. Interleaved practice promotes the ability to transfer knowledge to real-world situations. By practicing the application of vocabulary in diverse contexts, learners are better equipped to use the words effectively in various communication scenarios. 4. Overcoming illusion of learning. Block practice can create a false sense of mastery where learners feel confident about a particular set of vocabulary items because they have studied them in isolation. Interleaved practice, on the other hand, exposes learners to the challenges of recalling vocabulary in mixed contexts, which helps to identify areas of weakness and guide further study. 5. Long-term retention. The cognitive effort required during interleaved practice strengthens memory pathways, leading to more durable and longer-lasting retention of the vocabulary. This is particularly important for language learning, where vocabulary needs to be readily accessible over an extended period. It's worth noting that interleaved practice can be more challenging and may lead to a temporary dip in performance compared to blocked practice in the short term. However, the long-term benefits in terms of improved retention and application of vocabulary make it a valuable technique for language learners. Rohrer and Taylor's 2007 study, along with subsequent research, supports the idea that interleaved practice is a powerful learning strategy that can be effectively applied to learning English vocabulary and other types of knowledge. Learners can experiment with this approach by deliberately mixing vocabulary items from different categories or topics in their study sessions to experience the benefits firsthand.